Hello, Future Pros. We have something a little bit different today. I kind of just want to try a brew out in Historic. I did find this on Twitter. I believe I already wrote a deck highlight on it. So if you want to, actually, I could just check it out so we can give the person a proper shout out. Let's see. OB. It is a Bolas's Citadel deck that improved quite a bit with the with some of the new cards from Adventures from the Forgotten Realms. And let me actually find out the name of the person who built this deck. But yeah, Prosperous Innkeeper seems really good for this deck because first of all, you make a treasure, so it helps you speed up, you know, the mana development to get the Bolas's Citadel out as early as possible. And then when you have it in play, it also makes it easier to just keep chaining spells off of the Citadel. So that's a pretty good pickup for this deck. Shambling Gas doesn't seem that great to me, honestly. Like if it created the thing or if it did the thing like as it enters play, that'd be a different story. But then it would probably be a little too good. This way you have to sacrifice it to actually get something out of the something out of it, which is a little, you know, a little less great, but we'll see how it plays out. Deadly Dispute is also something that I would probably just rather replace with like an actual creature, like a fourth priest, for example, because priest is just great. Auras is a big part of the metagame right now, so I wouldn't mind having access to that. And the person is Will Erker. You can follow Will on Twitter if you want to get some updates about this deck. It is actually just twitter.com/WillErker. Okay, sideboard is like a little bit of everything. I like that there's a lot of creatures, or well, half of the sideboard's creatures, 40%. Six of the 15 cards are creatures. Scavenging Ooze and Reclamation Sage you can both find with company, and like it's a deck that you don't really want to sideboard too many non-creature cards. But the problem with Jund is that there's not that many great creatures to company for anyway. But yeah, let's see how it plays out. I like the two Phyrexian Towers. The rest of the deck is pretty much standard. But again, yeah, I'm curious how this is going to play out, but I think this is a replaceable card. If you want to just add like, you know, one more priest, two more artists and like something else, then I think that would be a very reasonable switch to make. Traditional, historic, ranked. Let's go. I haven't played on Arena in quite some time. And the rank just reset, so I think this is probably good for the deck. We're gonna be trying this in the gold ranks. might just work out. Speaker of the Heavens, alright. So I need to put this on black, I'm pretty sure. I can go Innkeeper into Goose. I don't think I'm going to be using this for playing Goose. It's actually, if I had a Citadel in my hand, then I can just play the Goose and I can play the Citadel on turn 3. That would be actually kind of sick. I think there probably should be the fourth Citadel in the deck because of how important it is to get it. It's going to be some kind of Angel. Yeah, some kind of Angel's deck. This seems a little bit too slow to me. What's the play? I think the play is just Vostrider and a Goose. And I'm gonna start sacking some tokens and I'm just gonna try to scry into the Citadel because we do need it. We do need to find it as soon as possible. Yep, That's okay. That's also okay. I'm not gonna say no to company. It's not a citadel, but I mean, if I just find a mayhem devil, that's gonna be pretty good. I think I'm gonna do it on my own turn. There's no real reason to wait. Yeah, I'm just gonna do it right now. Mayhem devil is good, priest is good. Oh, now we're, wait a minute. We're both gonna be gaining some life, but how do I wanna do this? This is only as a sorcery, right? Yeah. So I think I just want to shoot these two. The question is, what do I sacrifice? I can't just sack two treasures. I don't have enough mana to play this, right? If I sack two treasures for mana, then I don't have the third to do it. So, I could definitely sack like one Gilded Goose, for example. I have a timeout? I have one timeout. I can sack one goose because with the priest I'm gonna have six mana. So I can sack one goose and one treasure. I think that makes sense. Instead of sacking this guy. I think this guy's gonna be good for, yeah. So sacrifice a treasure token. Shoot this thing. And then I'll sacrifice a goose to shoot the other thing. I don't want a goose. I have a treasure and a food token. So, wait, I can actually play this. I forgot that this was a treasure, not a food token. I didn't actually have to sack the goose. Okay, so now, okay. I definitely, that was the what I should have done is, I'm a little confused with what's actually going on. What I should have done is, I think I should have sacked the treasure. Instead of the goose, I should have sacked the treasure to make one more mana and then use my goose to create a food token. That would have been a lot better. Sure. Oh boy, there's going to be a lot of triggers. Okay, so I think we're playing Merchant first. Tapping the elf, yeah, I think they know what's up. So I would play this guy by tapping the elf that makes a treasure, then I sack the treasure and pay one mana to play Blood Artist. So I have all this in play, I have one trigger, so that shoots the speaker, and then I can use Priest by sacking two more creatures and something else, probably to Vostrider. That is gonna kill the Resplendent Angel. With the three triggers, then they have to sacrifice, and I'm gonna start drawing cards, and yeah, that would have been okay. So against angels, I don't even think this is very good because human cleric, this is a 1/4. This I don't really mind that much. The other big angel is a 2/4. So I think what I want is Vraska. I probably want Fatal Push. It seems pretty good to me, actually. And I don't think this card is going to be dying at all against a deck with mostly flyers. Also, this just doesn't seem that great. So I'll just put one of these back in. Should I just have this in anyway? It really doesn't seem very good. Like, they have so many 2/4s and 1/4s and everything. Good mana, good cards, good curve.
Can't really ask for much more.
The question is, do I want to play this on turn one? I think I do. If they play the 1/4, I want to kill it. Oh. Yeah. Get this guy out of here. I think I only need one red source. At the same time, I don't really need that many green ones either, so maybe I just do this on red. Innkeeper. Yeah, this card is really nice for this deck. Just gaining life when you're going off with Citadel. I can definitely get used to that. So now I can play Mayhem Devil, and next turn I can fire off the Company. Seems good to me. Oh wait, I can just fire off Company right now. That's probably better. Oh yeah, that's definitely better. Wow, this is great. This, okay, I like it. Oh wow, this card still exists. Oof. Oh my god, can I actually beat this? I already used my Fatal Push. Wow, that's brutal. I don't even know if I want to play the Company. I guess I want to. That is actually insane. Oh my god, I don't think I can beat this card right now. So normally you can at least sacrifice Fabled Passages, but I don't think I have anything that's going to let me sack against the Yasharn. I have no fetch lands or anything like that, so I'm literally just going to have to win by attacking or blocking. That's going to be quite a challenge. That is going to be quite a challenge. So basically, I just need to find more companies and then just like find more blood artists. But I think I'm probably like 1% to win this game. Oh wow, they're running this as well. Yeah, I guess it makes sense. They want to gain life with the bishop. And the 2/4 angel and the 1/1 that makes tokens. Yeah, that makes sense. This card is a lot better than people can give it credit for. I think there is only two blood artists in the deck, so I don't actually think I can win right now. Like, even if I find the second one, like, that's gonna be it. And then, like, you know, I would be able to start, like, chump attacking. But I don't think that's gonna be good enough. Yep. Okay, well, I can do something with that. Actually, this is gonna take too long. I should have just tried to go ultimate with this. And then just have more creatures in play. I think that could technically work. Wait, is it actually going to let me... Oh, wait a minute. You can actually do that? To cast spells or activate abilities. Oh, I can actually sacrifice. So I should have played the Mayhem Devil first. I didn't realize I can do that. That is interesting. Oh, wow. It does work. Holy crap. It actually works. Actually works. Okay, my bad. It's only to activate abilities. And this is not being activated by that. It's being activated by putting two counters on the Vraska. So that's why it works. Okay. What a game. I thought I was 100% dead, but now I'm starting to think that I might actually have a chance. Oh my god, are we doing it? So this I wouldn't be able to activate because... Can pay life or sacrifice to activate abilities. This is literally being activated by... Paying two and sacrificing. So, I mean, I'm just going to put it in play just to see if I really do understand it correctly. Oh my god, so many triggers. Oh boy. What is happening? One. Two. Target you. Oh my god, are we actually gonna beat Ayasharn? That's unreal. Should I play this? I think it's better to just make a food token, actually. I'll just keep it in my hand. Oh wait, I can also start attacking with the 3-2. I can attack with the Vostrider. Because then I can finish off the Ayasharn. This is unfortunate. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm attacking with the Vostrider. Not with the Mayhem Devil, but with the Vostrider for sure. They can just trade it for two, but then I can bring it back. If one more thing. I have three in the yard or two? Three. So if I sack a creature. Yeah, let's do that. Now I just want to do the ultimate thing. 4, 5, 6, I have 7 creatures that can attack. Oh, this is bad. This is bad. Okay. I guess it's not the end of the world. Next turn I can jump with the goose and protect Vraska, and then I can ultimate it. They shouldn't have conceded. They can still find a glass gasket. Like next turn, if they draw a glass gasket and exile my goose, then I can't actually block the flyer. So they would be able to start taking down the loyalty. I'm gonna change the list a little bit because I can already see like how some of the cards are better and how some of the cards are just much more necessary for the game plan. That was actually interesting. I didn't think I had the slightest chance. A braid. I'm just gonna. What kills Yasharn? Noxious Grasp, Fatal Push. If you already have something in play, you can sacrifice in response to Yasharn being cast, so that you trigger Revolt, and then you can play it after it hits play. I mean, it sounds better than a braid, actually. I don't know if there are like very many artifacts. So just cut the two abrades and just hit two Fatal Pushes in the sideboard, just so I have some Yasharn answers. Although, yeah, I'm gonna play two and one Grasp, because Grasp is gonna be better. If I play against like a banned ramp deck, I'm not gonna bring in Fatal Pushes. I also don't think I need Witch's Vengeance. I'm just gonna have one more Grasp in the deck. I'm just gonna do it like that. Oh yeah, in the main deck, I'm gonna change the Deadly Dispute. I don't think I want that, and I really don't think I want these guys either, or these guys. So, Priest, Artist, and we can add one more card. I think I'm just gonna add the Citadel. I mean, four is a little too many, but let's give it a try. I would like to play first. And it's a lot of three drops, and I don't really have red mana. Giganta showing. I think I'm just mulliganing into something faster. This looks a lot better. I can't play Giganta, right? Because I'm playing Citadel, yeah. Inquisition. Where are they playing? What deck plays Inquisition and Giganta? Maybe they're just playing some like non-company Jund? Oh wow, okay, that's the 5-mana 6/6 deck. I think I'm playing the Strider and waiting for next turn. And next turn I'll try to just draw into Citadel and hope that works out. I'm gonna have 4, 5, 6 mana. I wonder if I play the Goose, I don't think so. Exile, I can't really do anything about that. I don't wanna sack the token because I wanna use it into the Priest. Actually, wait a minute. I'm gonna make mana. Yeah, I just have to hope that I find Citadel. Actually, I should do red mana. Red, sack this. Submit 1, 2. Alright, Citadel or bust. Company's good too. I'll take that as well. So this is going to leave me with green. I mean, I don't really have any butchers or anything, so that's okay. Here comes the extinction event. Drone is okay. That's actually okay. It's not the end of the world. So let's do the same thing again. Wait for next turn. Try to find Citadel. Gonna keep the priest on tap just in case they have another removal spell or some kind of sweeper or something. An untapped land, okay. Are we going for it? I can also just attack. Like, that's not the worst either. I think I'm attacking. I'm attacking with both, actually. Because they don't have a lot of life. Now I can play Citadel anyway if I draw into it. Cycle Triome, that's good for me. Sure. Yeah, that makes a token. I think. Now that they're on 8, I would be attacking for 1. I think I hold it back. No, no, let's just save it. Let's just send it in. I'm kind of hoping they're going to have to play the Giganta, and I would just be able to priest them. Just like every damage counts. Like, especially with like having Mayhem Devils in my deck. If I at any point draw a Mayhem Devil, I want to be able to like lethal them. And like right now, I would be able to sack 1, 2, 3... three things and then double priest. So like, yeah, every damage really counts. Like now if I draw Mayhem Devil, I think I exactly lethal them. Oh, I wanted to make a token, damn. Well, that is a good draw. That is a really good draw. So how do we do this? I think I keep the priest on tap. Okay. Okay, hello. Oh my god, we're doing it. We're actually doing it. So now I can priest and sag the rest into just be like being treasures. I think we have lethal. Okay. Sacrifice this and this. That's 6, and then I can just sack a treasure. And that's game! This deck is nice! Oh, what do I want? This kills the big flyer, kills Hydroid if I want to. It also kills Yasharn, so that's coming in for sure. And I don't really think I want any of the other cards. Maybe Vraska is okay. Like, they have a lot of, like, one-for-one removal. Vanishing Verse doesn't kill it. So again, I'm going to just board this crap out. And I think I want the two Vraskas. Question is, would I board out? Probably. Can board out like a Blood Artist, and they're gonna have some sweepers. Like maybe I can also board out like a Llanowar Elf, maybe one Innkeeper. Yeah, not bad. I'm also not sure if like if this land is supposed to be in the deck. Like you want to have all your lands be able to produce black. So having four just straight up red-green duels, not sure if that's ideal. At the same time, you obviously want to have as many untapped green sources as well, but I think there already are enough sources for that. I guess we're going red now. Well, tease, yeah, make your pick. It's okay. Playing Bowstrider first. Doing the graveyard. Actually, I'm not gonna have six now. That's unfortunate. Yeah, that resolves. I wanted to have that in play earlier. Because I would rather have them drown the Mayhem Devil than that. Like that card in play seems better than Mayhem Devil. Because I can just sack all the creatures there. Can't cast cards from libraries. Okay, so that's not gonna do anything. That's unfortunate. So the only thing Ball Citadel does right now is, unless I find Vraska to kill this, is I'm just gonna know what I draw, and if I have 10 permanents, I can do something really cool. Helix. That's fine. Yeah, like look at my mana base. Like there's no way playing Stomping Grounds and Pathways is the way to go with like triple black cards in your deck. That sounds really suspicious. I assume if they had a sweeper, they would have played it last turn. Because they know I have 2 6 mana artifacts in my hand. What the hell? What? Didn't they have 5 cards in hand? What do you have? Like 5 Niv-Mizzets? What is going on? I guess if they literally don't have anything to cast, I'm gonna hit them to 4, and then even if they play the 6, they still die. Okay, let me change the mana base, because this is not ideal. Okay, let's open the pack. What do we get? Some nice mythic. Oh, not so nice. Yeah, let's take a look at the mana base, because this is not right. Yeah, maybe I'm just lucky and I just drew too many of these. There is only 8 red sources. So let's see. Round 1 untap green, or turn 1 untap green swords. There's 11. That's about how you should have for birds. So Stomping Grounds is okay, but Pathway, I think, should just be like more Blood Crypts. Or the black red pathway. So I didn't change the number of red sources. What the hell? Didn't change the number of red sources. 1, 2, 3, 6. Wait, is that really only 8 red sources? I do have Gilded Goose, but that's still not that many. And green, I have 11, 15. Yeah, these should be black-red ones for sure. I'm gonna add these pathways. 15 green sources has to be enough. Looks good. Blooming Marsh. Yeah. Okay, we're pretty well set up for a citadel. Can we ever find one? Okay, is it Phoenix? So that's gonna be a real test. Not sure if I want to play the Gilded Goose, and the answer is I don't think so, because next turn I can play Mayhem Devil. I didn't show them the red source on purpose. Next turn I can play Mayhem Devil, and then I can use Goose to make mana, play another Goose. So that's going to be one trigger, and then I can sack the double Goose to have two more triggers and make them sack something. So even if they like make this bigger, play another creature or something, I'm still going to be able to deal with their board. Okay. Oh boy. Okay, now I think I'm just casting company. Yeah, now I think I'm just casting company. I'm just gonna do it right away. Like, there's no real reason to wait. Oh my god. Is it too greedy to take double devil? Since I only have one way to sacrifice things? I don't think so. It's just so good. And I'm not gonna attack with this. Yeah, that's not the most threatening thing ever. I wonder if I can just like lethal them next turn. I wouldn't be shocked if I could. So, play Gilded Goose, make a treasure, sack the treasure, that's two triggers, play Devil, and then I can... Then I have... I don't have any more treasures, or food tokens rather, but I can sack these two. That's 6 damage, 8 damage. 10, 16. Oh no, it's. I want to time out. I don't think that's lethal though. I don't think I can do 20. Oh wait, it was lethal. I could have targeted myself as well. So let's say I deal 2 to them. That's 18, No. Now priest is 8. That's 10. I also target myself. So it's 13, 19. Am I one short? Am I just doing this math wrong? 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 3 more is 13. I think I'm only doing 19. But if you guys figure it out, let me know. Let me know in the comments if I just missed lethal. I mean, their board is gonna be empty, and like I'm just gonna have everything plus the blood artist and all that. So worst case scenario, I'll just kill them next turn. But I think it's likely that there could have been lethal somewhere. I don't know. Didn't really want to time out doing that. Fatal push is probably okay. Again, I'm just gonna board this guy out. That's a nice thing about playing this in the main deck. You always have something to board out. Raska, I don't think so. This looks good. Goose, yeah, that seems like a good, hand. Pathway. Wonder if I want a mana guy. I can play two mana guys if I put this on green, but I really don't want to put this on green. I'm just playing the priest. Wow, that's a bold move. Oh, well, I should have actually boarded out a Citadel or two, because this is a matchup where I don't think I'm going to be in a position to really spend a lot of life to do that. It's really expensive. So I think, yeah, that would have probably been better. I think I'm playing Mayhem Devil now. Now I have really awkward mana. Kind of need to do this on green, as much as I hate it. But this is going to give me double black, so that's okay. So green and play Devil. And next turn I can go Devil. Still doesn't really do much. Yeah, I should have had two more Vraskas in my deck instead of two Citadel. This is not a matchup where I can just spend infinite life on Citadels and... Yeah, that wouldn't have worked. Now I'm just gonna die to the flyer, probably. Even though Vraska doesn't really kill everything they play, like it only really kills this guy, and like maybe if they have like a, you know, young Firemancer, although it doesn't really make sense for them to have Firemancer for this matchup, I'm gonna be dead before I can do anything. So now I have to play... Goose into this. I can't really jump. 9. And I need the mana from this. Yeah, I mean, sure. I don't know if there's anything. What would the top of my deck need to be? I would need to go Innkeeper into like a bunch of one mana guys. Because then I would be... Oh no, that doesn't even work because I'm still on one and I can't pay for the... I think I'm actually just dead on board. I can block and double sack this to stay alive. That actually works. So that's better than playing the Citadel. So yeah, I can actually kill one of them. So that's fine. But better? That has to be better. Yeah, that has to be better. Should probably do it right now. Sack double food, kill the 3/3. I go to 9 and I put them to 10. And there is a small chance I don't even have to chump block. I can also make double black from this. This sack something, this sack something. I can sack 3 things, so they puts them to 5. What's the best way to do it? Should I play the Citadel anyway? And try to find like... No, that doesn't work. If 3 timeouts. Yeah, I think my best play is just sacking the food. I can play Citadel next turn anyway. Oh my god. Oh no. There goes my chance of winning. Okay. That was brutal. I could have Inquisition, but I also don't like that too much. It's gonna be better than this though. I just actually get rid of all of them. I just have the double Raska. This is gonna be better like this. Yep. Oh wait, this is oof. This looked like a black source. I guess we have a black source here, but that's not a great hand. It's like it just doesn't do anything. Like we have a 1/1 and a 0/1 and like no pressure, no company, no anything. I think I would have mulliganed. Actually, would I have mulliganed? It's really borderline. I'm not gonna play the Inquisition. I think I wanna get the devil in play. That I can kill with a bush, so it's okay. Actually, I can kill it with the... Oh, I can't. Damn. Wow, imagine if this is a black source. I just play the Mayhem Devil, sag this to get black, kill this in the process, and Inquisition them. Yeah, that would have been okay. Yeah, I have to do it like this. Can't really. Wait, what? What is it? What is happening? No, don't do that. What? You were not supposed to do that. I mean, I guess it's not the worst, but that's not what I wanted to do. Finale Shock, Looting, Crackling Drake, and the 1-1. The 1-1 I think they can keep. I think I'm getting rid of Finale. They don't really have anything for it right now, but like down the road, this is going to be the best card for them. Yeah, I really wish I had the 1-1 in play. I wouldn't have gotten to cast the Inquisition right now, but I think that would have been still worth it. Okay, nice. That's a black source. I think I'm... Actually, am I playing Fatal Push on it? I think that can probably wait. Like, if they play Crackling Drake, I would rather kill the Crackling Drake. So I'm fine taking one more hit from this. Yep. Play this, make a token, sag the token. Am I one mana short? Can I kill both? Play this guy, make a token. I'm gonna have to sag the Blood Artist, I think. Play this guy, make a, if this was a treasure, it would have also been better. Play this guy, make a token. Sack the token into tower. Then I can use push on this, and then I have to sack Blood Artist. That's fine though. So this turn gets this guy. This targets them. They look, no, good. This targets this thing. This triggers. Now I sag the Blood Artist. Okay. Ping your thing, ping you. I don't want to land. Now what I want to find is Collected Company. And hope that they don't find a Anger of the Gods. That's fine. So we have 6 in play, 7, 8 with the Mayhem Devil. That's fine. Don't think I have anything relevant in the graveyard. I wonder, I think I didn't get to attack with this when I cast my, when I accidentally used the Phyrexian Tower. So that might have been a, that might have been the one extra damage. Like now I can sack the food and I can sack the Mayhem Devil to put them exactly at 1. That could have been the... Wait, can I... I can do it anyway. No, I can't do it. No, I can't kill them. Oh, well, they just killed themselves. Should I do it in response? Probably not. They still have to act first. Like, this is the kind of situation where you don't really need to do anything. You just win next turn if you just attack with your creatures, so no reason to go try to go lethal right now. That was nice. This deck was actually pretty good. The Innkeeper is really, really strong. I didn't really like the other cards. Treasures would have been a lot better, obviously, than some of the other cards. Like, I didn't really draw the 1-1 too much. But like just thinking about it, like there's a lot of situations where like it's not gonna die, like it's just, you know, a one mana, one one, like you have to sacrifice it into something to get a treasure, which is just not easy all the time. But that looked pretty good. I did really like this. I was pleasantly surprised. Like, we obviously, you know, we didn't play against like a Jessica control deck or something, but those decks, like if you just resolve Citadel against those decks, they're just not gonna have a lot of good answers to it. So that was nice. I was pleasantly surprised how this played out. I mean, it's obviously it's just a Junt, you know, Junt sacrifice shell, which is never gonna be too bad. But yeah, I think we fixed the mana base. Like, this should be a lot better. I think we also just kind of fixed the creature base. And yeah, that was good. That was actually pretty good. So if you want to give it a try, definitely can recommend. Especially if you already have the Junt cards, like you don't really have to craft too much to play this. But obviously, you know, with the Modern Horizon things, who knows how much is this format gonna change? Probably a lot. Anyways, thanks for watching. Make sure you check out cfbboxbreaks.com if you want to open some of the new cards, and if you want to just read all the deck guides and everything, I'll probably make a deck guide on this. You can find all that on channelfireball.com. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.